Hello and welcome to today's video.
Today we are outside and I have my chalk with me. Now my chalk consists of new chalk and older chalk, but we're going to be using a consistency of both. In this box I have here, I have brand new chalk and old chalk all in one. In this box I have three compartments, and in this compartment I have this special thing. This helps you draw circles. So what you do is you connect all four of these pieces together. I may be missing one because it sat out here the other day. I forgot it was out here. But you connect all four of these pieces and it makes a perfect circle. I'll come up closer so you can see it. It makes a perfect circle. You can either draw on the inside, or you can draw on the outside, or you can draw, put the chalk right here and go like this, and that makes a perfect circle. Now I've already drawn on some of my chalk on my driveway, but I haven't drawn on all of it yet. So I plan on drawing on all of it this week. I bought some more chalk, so be prepared for more chalk videos. But we're just going to draw a basic octopus today. I might even use that. So I'm going to get my chalk out. Get that aside real quick. I'm going to get my chalk out. And I don't know what colors I'm going to choose yet. But we're going to see what colors we're going to do. Now I'm going to use this for the head. So I think I'm going to do a purple and green one because I have a lot of purple and green. So we're going to use purple and green, and we're going to use yellow for the tentacles. So if you're a beginner chalk artist, there's a couple of tips that I'm going to give throughout this video. Yeah, we have a little bit of yellow, so we're going to use some yellow. So I'm going to use this as the base for the head, but I think I'm going to start off with purple. We may even use this pretty orange. I don't know if you can tell, but we may use that. I will tell you, when you're outside chalking, the first tip, come out when it's just morning time. I just went on my walk, and so I decided to come out while I'm still out here and chalk, and it's like almost 7. So I would suggest coming out at 7, and it's still cool outside, because when you're outside and it's hot, the sun will drain you. I will warn you. You want to drink lots of water as you're coming out here to draw. So, and some of my chalks are marbled. I think this one's marbled, but you can tell at the tip of the chalk, like there's different colors mixed in. So if it looks different on camera, that's why. So I've got the base going. And I don't have a picture to reference. I'm just going off of memory here on what a octopus looks like. I know it has a big head. So you're going to want to first do the head. And then you're going to want to color in the head. And now you can make this a cartoon octopus and put like eyes and a mouth. And that's what I'm going to do with today's octopus, because I like to draw cartoons. So yeah. And one tip to get a lot of coverage in, some people like to use the width of it, but you can use the flat side of it. And just go like this, and it will get a lot, but I will say it will come up. It will get a lot more space that way. So there's the head of the octopus. And you're going to want to have some colors. You're going to want to have are white and black and brown. Because those are rare chalk colors, but I just ordered a kit
of 160 pieces, I think, that has white, black, and brown. So you're going to want to get white, black, and brown because those are border colors. And what that means is that they're outline colors. So whenever you're doing a piece, you can outline the piece with the white, black, and brown. And I will say it will use a lot of your chalk if you go like this. But if you use the little nib, it won't use as much chalk. That's a tip number one. And if you want to get your chalk smooth, you can use either a sponge, a cloth, or some water. But I just use my hands. Because when you come outside with your chalk, you don't have a lot of space. We may try some water tips in the future, but for now we're just going to use our hands. And you don't have to use white, black, and brown. You can just use different colors. So, like, if you're doing a flower, you can do different colors. I'm just going to add a couple of dark purple in here. Yeah, that looks cool. And I will tell you, your hands are going to get a little messy. So if you don't like getting messy or you don't like the chalk feel, because my brother doesn't like the chalk feel, you can wear gloves. That's a tip number two for you. So I'm going to scoop back some. I'm going to scoop back. And I'm going to get another purple out. And we're just going to come off the ends of it. Come off this end of it. And it's kind of like a tree. You're just going to make it like a tree. So we've got our two back legs. And we're going to work on their inside legs in just a minute. I don't know if you can tell on camera. But what you can do is you can come out here with the back legs and make it like a little squirrel. So there's the first leg. Now you're going to do the second leg just like that, but in the opposite direction. There we go. So we have our two back legs. Now we're going to work on the front legs. And I will tell you, when you color it in, it's not going to look so weird. Because right now it looks kind of weird, doesn't it? But we're just going to come back out. And you're going to want to put two lines. As you're coming out with the legs. And you can add more legs. You can add as many legs as you want because an octopus has like 8 legs, I think. And did you know that octopus has 3 stomachs? So, never know. You learn something new every day. But I will tell you story time. One time I was chalking. And I chalk a lot, so. One time I was chalking. And I went over a crack in the sidewalk, in the drawing, and 1,000 ants came out. So be careful where you chalk. You want to check the spot before you start chalking because you don't want to get 1,000 ant bites like I did. But yeah, and you will get bit by ants and spiders. But from being out here, I haven't really gotten bit by anything. So I guess it just depends on what time of the season is and when you come out and stuff like that. But right now is a good time because it's starting to turn cool. And this is where you want to come out and draw. So, our first one is an octopus. Our next one might be a unicorn. I don't know. We'll see. So, now we're going to fill it in. So, fill it in, fill it in. And you can use your hand. You can use your foot. You can get some water. And that will help not spread it out more. Like, it'll help it stay dry. And it makes a cool effect.
So we're going to do the second leg. And if you wanted to, you could do purple on the inside legs too. And then draw like more legs in the between. And then draw a different color on top of the legs to separate the colors. Like yellow. You could even do pink. This is looking more like a jellyfish than an octopus. And you may be wondering, why do I have so much chalk? Well, this one's empty. These two are full. This one's full or half full. But you go through a lot of chalk when you're doing big pieces. So I try to keep a lot on hand because, like, you don't want to run out of chalk. That's not fun. So, yeah. So we're just gonna keep on filling in. And stay tuned for more videos because I do videos all the time. And so, I go on Facebook and do Facebook Lives. And I go on TikTok and do TikTok videos. But those aren't usually chalk videos. Those are usually like just talking videos. But I may start doing chalk ones now that it's nice outside. Let's see. I'm going to do... So you want to get a white... Ooh, got a hair on me. You're going to get a white. And you're going to get... I just have a sliver of a black. A sliver of a black. And now we're going to start adding detail on it. So, I just added the eyes. I don't know if you can tell, but our octopus is starting to come together. So now you're going to want to color in the eyes. And if you could, if you wanted to, you could have left a little blank spot for the eyes so that there's not purple in behind them. But, yeah. So now we're going to get this little sliver and add the eyes. Oh, this is a cool octopus, you guys. And you can do the mouth. There we go. So, now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to get a red or pink for the tongue. And there you have it. There's the basic octopus. Now I'm going to add a couple more purple because it doesn't look filled all the way. And I want this to be really pigmented. So to do that, you just come back with the second layer. So now I'm going to get a green. And now I have like four different kinds of greens. I think I'm going to use this color. It's not really a green, it's more of a sea green. I don't know if you could tell. But I'm going to start with the bottom legs while I'm down here and just go around it. Just going to go around it. And then for the tentacles, I will tell you what to do for the tentacles next. Underwater theme over here. Okay, now I'm going to come up here and do the head.
Okay.
So now we're going to come back down and do the tentacles. And now this could be fun because there's a lot of them. So you could do a mixture of colors. You could do like yellow and orange, or you could do like pink and purple, or you could do like, I don't know. You could do all kinds of colors. But you're just going to want to make circles. You can make them as big or as small as you want. Dark or as light as you want. And you want to go all the way down. So. So we've got 3 out of the 4 legs done. So now we're going to get the last one done, and we'll be done. So, there's our octopus. There's our tips and tricks. Thank you for joining, and be careful for rocks, and because you don't want to get a rock in your hand or in your foot, and have lots of chalk on hand. And you can have water on hand to spread the chalk. So, thank you for joining, and God bless.